गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड द व्यूअर. आई एम प्रोफेसर अश्वथी फुलझेले, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. वेलकम्स यू ऑल फॉर द कंप्यूटर एप्लीकेशन टू प्रैक्टिकल, विच मेनली डील्स विद द डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, एज यू कैन सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन, वी हैव रिट्रीव्ड सेवरल टेबल फ्रॉम द ड्राइव एंड वी आर गोइंग टू सिलेक्ट अ पर्टिकुलर टेबल फ्रॉम द एग्जिस्टिंग टेबल एज द स्टूडेंट टेबल. Wherein you can see three columns are there, name, roll number and the branch. If you wish to alter modify the structure of the existing table, we can modify according to the requirement. So for doing so, we have created one new table as create table student 1 as select star from student 1. Thus accordingly a new table with the table title as student 1 will be created. By clicking enter, you will get new table with the same entity as name, roll number and the branch, as the message is showing to you all as table is created. Right, that it means a new table with same entity is created. Now select star from student 1. All the entities can be seen here. Now we wish to modify or rearrange the structure of this student table 1. We can give the command as create table student 1 as select name, roll number from student 2. We have modified, we have created one another table as student 2 from the existing table, two column, which these two column are name and as the message is shown here like table is created. Now select star from student 2. New table of title student 2 is created with two column as name and number. If we wish to drop this table, we can give the command drop table 2. As you can see, the message is given like table drop. Now if we wish to give command like select star from student 2, you can see the error is there. Right, why the error is shown? Because we have already dropped this command, we have already dropped this table. So the system is unable to retrieve the data from student table 2 as we have already dropped this. Now if we wish to alter the structure of this table, we are giving the command as DESC student, with the help of which we can give we can alter the values of this table. Now here if you wish to change the structure of the table, we have alteration command. Apart from that, we have update command. With the combination of these multiple command, we can change the structure of this table. Right, what kind of alteration we wish to do, we can modify the values or the roll number and many of the things. We can see we have created one table student 2 from the existing table with the column as no name and roll number. The table is created with the title student 2. Now we are going to give command like select star from student 2. As you can see on your screen, there are two columns from student 2, name and roll number. Now if you wish to delete a particular entity, we are going to give the command as delete from student 2. Now from delete from student 2, the message is showing like 5 rows at it. Why this happened? We have not mentioned the particular which entity to delete. So the system was unable to recognize, or it was unaware about the entity to be deleted from student table 2. Thus, the system has deleted all the rows from student 2 table, right? If we select star from student 2, as there are no rows, the system is showing the result as no rows is selected. Now select star from student 1. We have already created one student 1 table, so as a result we can see on your screen name, roll number and branch. Now next command, delete from student 1, where name equals to Ria. Now let's run this query from student 1 table. 0 row is deleted. This message is shown on your screen. Why? Because the table is having no entry with capital R in the Ria. As you can see on your screen, we have entered, while giving the command, we have entered capital R in the Ria. So as a result, 0 row is deleted. That it means the system is case sensitive. This is case sensitive, that is why we will have to be very conscious while giving those commands. So now next we will give command like delete from student 1, where name is equals to small r Ria. As a result, you can see one row is deleted. Select star from student 1. As a result, you can see on your screen no row with the name Ria. You can see on your screen there is no more row with the name Ria. If we have several entities with the name Ria, all the entities will get deleted with the title as Ria, right? As a result, all the rows with the name Ria will be deleted. Now delete from student 1, where name is equals to Ria and roll number is equals to 123. Now I have mentioned one condition, delete from Ria and roll number equals to 123. As result is showing, 0 row is deleted. Why? Because although we have one entity having roll number 123 is there, because why it is not deleted? Because we are using an operator as AND here. That is why 0 row is deleted. AND means both conditions should be true. We have the entity Ria, we have the roll number 123, but in the table of student 1 there is no entity with name Ria is there. That is why 0 row is deleted. Now we will recorrect this. Delete from student 1, where name is equals to Ria or roll number equal to 123, right? Suppose if we alter with 1233 as the roll number, let us see what the system shows to us. Let us check it out. if we see, we have given the command as R, so the system will delete either RIA or row number 123. As a result, you can see here, one row is deleted, that row having roll number 123. Now next command is the delete from student 1, where roll number greater than or equal to 200. Now let us change the condition as greater than equal to 150 from 200. Now let us check it out. Two rows are deleted. As in the table, there were two entities having roll number greater than 150. In the residual, you can observe only one row is there in the student table 1. Only one row is remaining. So, my dear friends, we have studied today the modification of table. Modification of table with the help of delete, alteration, right? Where we have observed that this is a case sensitive one, so we must be very cautious while giving the command, right? So that is all for today's online lecture on the database management system. We will stop today this practical session, and in next session we will come up with new topic. Thank you for your patience and your valuable time.